Well, guys, before the weekend is over, we do have a couple big things to talk about in regards to Spider-Man No Way Home and the giant box office. This includes everything worldwide, and well, it's the third biggest opening of all time. So right now, just to make this clear, we are not talking about the United States alone. We are talking about everything combined. International markets where the film has been out for about a day before it opened up in the United States. Some places like a day and a half if you're in like Australia, for example. But again, it all contributes to that first opening box office weekend that gets accounted for all the way through when it opened through the end of Sunday, wherever you live. Of course, everybody plugs in all the numbers, equations, and we get the final number that's made official by the studios and people working there. So Spider-Man No Way Home, as reported by Deadline First, I believe, has amassed $587 million in its global opening on its first weekend. This makes it Sony's biggest opening of all time, bar none. Nothing can compare to Sony's ever done with this. Now, of course, comparing it to some other films and some films in its own franchise, the one that's right behind it would be Spider-Man Far From Home, which again isn't really surprising, considering that film went on to make more than $1 billion and was Sony's biggest film of all time. Now, this thing is quite clearly a monster, and one would have to believe that if this thing came out in a time where there wasn't a pandemic and everything, you know, here, it probably would do even better. Again, we know that there were still people that are like, I don't want to go to a theater, or it's sold out, I'm not going to risk it, too many crowds. But again, this is just showing you the power of this film, the brand behind it, the nostalgia. And as I always say, nostalgia sells. You have to capitalize on that. And over the last couple of years, we've seen that nostalgia can make everything a hit if you just cater to those people. This had 20 years to pull from. Nothing surprising here. This is one of those things where you look at this number, and if it falls, let's say 70% next weekend globally, it's still on track to make over $1 billion. This thing looks like it's going to hit $1 billion faster than most people thought, which again is really good. And since we do have a, you know, Christmas weekend and everything coming up, there's a lot of factors to look at and just kind of, you know, be in shock by, because Christmas is always one of these things where you look at it and that weekend typically delivers. Again, we don't know how it's going to do in this time frame, but things would have to be going pretty good for the film going forward. Again, third biggest, that's insane, right? But this thing has proven, the audiences have spoken, the critics have spoken, this thing is huge. It's only realistically up from here. Like, it can't possibly go down anyway. So let's see what happens next, because my assumption is this thing is not going to stop for a while, and nothing's really going to try to even dethrone it. I mean, did you guys know that The Matrix and a new Kingsman film are coming? Or might be out? I'm not even sure. That's how lost in the shuffle things are. Two films I'm really looking forward to that barely anybody's talking about, because Spider-Man is literally all of it. It's dominated the entire conversation. And The Matrix is one of my top 25 films of all time. So the fact that I'm kind of looking at it going, oh yeah, that's coming out, really just shocks me. That's how terrible the marketing for that has been, and how good the marketing and push for Spider-Man has been.